Gabrielle's been through some really difficult times in her life, which I think have shaped her passion and the emotion. And just watching her kind of come into her own and help be, a messenger of such an important topic has really made her stand out from the rest.
Gabrielle being one of the very few Black female EDM artists in the scene, the fact that she even exists in the scene is a feat within itself.
What's up? My name is Gabrielle Watson. I go by 100 Drums. I live in Denver, Colorado, and this is about Enough is Enough.
October 2016 was the night of my assault, and I have every reason to believe that my race was an influence to that. One night I was at a friend's place and I was helping her pack because she was moving the next day. Her mother was flying into town. Basically, her roommate at the time made her feel very uncomfortable, and there have been a couple of incidences. And we're just chilling in her room. I'm helping her fold some clothes, I believe, and we're just talking. There's no music, there's no TV. We're just like talking, and I'm helping my girl pack. All of a sudden, her roommate barges into the room with a key that she didn't know he had, invaded our private space. And he immediately said, "Your inward friend needs to leave because I want to go to bed and I don't want her stealing from her house." And when he said the inward, he pointed at me.
Tell you a little bit about what it means to be Black in America. Being Black in America means constantly being judged by yourself, by strangers, by pop culture, by the police, by educators, by authority figures, by everyone. Being Black in America means being compared to whiteness and acceptable behavior, language, vernacular, all defined by whiteness. It means enduring being told, "I never would have guessed you were Black by the way that you talk," and being expected to take that as a compliment.
Being Black in America means always questioning whether it's appropriate to even be yourself. It means staying prepared to don the appropriate facade for the appropriate crowd. Now don't act too white, now don't act too Black. If you're too loud, you're branded as ghetto, or ratchet, or extra. Being Black in America means being a novelty and adopting the role of the token Black friend.
I actually wrote the piece 2021 at the end of Black History Month. I had sat there and watched other people tell me what it was like to be Black so much. So one morning, just during my endless doom scroll, I decided to start a note about what it means to be Black in America. And it flowed out of me so effortlessly. I apparently had a lot to say.
When I saw Leah's post, I cried for a while before I even approached her to do more with this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we all share so many of the same feelings. It just takes the one person to put those feelings into words.
Beautifully. So many more people need to hear it. It's not just her explaining to others how we feel about being Black in America. It's an educational piece. And it's just so beautiful and so big and so important that I felt like it was part of my duty to help uplift this message more. And it became a pivotal moment in the EP project, really. Like, it just really helped bring it all together because I know, like, I wanted this EP to be about the BLM movement and to be about pushing the bigger message and to also share my experience as a victim of a racial attack. And this is the piece, the cherry on top. And yeah, I'm really excited that Deadbeats is giving us a platform to really amplify the message here.
I'm just sitting there shocked, thinking, did he just call me the N-word? And she and I are sitting there like, whoa, what the heck just happened? We decided to leave. We did not feel safe there. We were just going to return back when her mom got into town. But before we leave, I had to use the bathroom. I forgot that I had to go since I got there, but I was just excited to be with her. And she felt really uncomfortable with me going to the bathroom, so she pulled out her phone and watched me walk down the hallway to the bathroom. As I come back out, my attacker is standing in between me and her. And he's so big that he was blocking my ability to enter either into the living room to leave or to go back into her room. And so as I approach and I'm like, oh my God, he's just like, you need to leave. And I said, I will, as long as my friend can leave with me. And I tried to squeeze past him, and that's when he picked me up and he throws me on the ground and he kicked me twice in my ribs. I lost breath of air. I was gasping for a little bit. And my friend freaks out. She's still recording, and she picks up my phone and she calls the police. She's trying to talk to dispatch. I'm trying to get myself back up off the floor. My attacker chose to attack me again. He grabbed me by my hair and my arm and dragged me into another part of the house, and I'm fearing for my life yet again. And when I finally get out of his grip, I run to my friend's room and grab her, grab my things. We climb out of her bedroom window, and literally as I'm helping her climb down, all the four cop cars come up and they get on the curb, like skirted on the curb, point their guns at us for a moment and tell us to separate. And as we do, separating, crawling on the ground, they're all pointing their guns at me. I had guns in my face. And I don't know what's going to happen. But after some deliberation, my friend showing the police the video of my attacker beating the shit out of me twice, they decide to take me to jail. They didn't read me my rights. They wouldn't answer any questions. They wouldn't let me see medical for 12 days. That's how long they kept me jailed for, with no ability to bail. My public defender came and basically told me that if I was a white girl with money, this would go different for me. Everything just came crashing down so quickly. In jail, I was treated like shit, and it was a horrible experience, and it took months of spending a lot of money for a criminal defense lawyer and a private investigator to fight for my freedom.
They're a good summarization of 100 Drums' journey and where she's at right now as a producer. You have everything from a roots-influenced vibe to a dark dungeon dubstep kind of style, classic wobble, and everything has like a hip-hop California influence, which I can really get down with. Mixing and mastering this project, part of the process has been teaching Gabriel how to be a better engineer and a better producer, and just kind of going through the process of polishing up the track once you have an idea laid there.
I think that Gabriel makes really unique music because it's very connected to the earth. It feels very primal and tribal. And so when it hits that like deep, deep tone, it really just feels like, you know, like something very instinctual. When I'm thinking about how to animate it, I'm trying to figure out how to really bring the piece to life and embody the original spirit of it so that you can feel the original feeling behind the art piece in a more interactive way that can sync up with the music. And when I'm performing live with Gabrielle, I'm trying to listen to the tracks that she's playing, and I use different elements that are audio reactive so that it really brings the whole thing together, and you can hear every distinct detail in the music as it's visualized on the screen. It just brings more attention to those details.
I think it's really important for Gabrielle to use her music and her platform to, you know, teach and educate people about BLM. Not only is she a Black woman, she is a staple in our community, and the music she creates is very inspirational and moving, and when she can tie in such an important topic that's been around for quite a while now, I think she really brings light to it in a different way.
So sharing my story, allowing myself to be vulnerable, and this is why I'm doing this, because of the way I was treated, the unjust for me, the beating, the jails, the courts, the attorney fees, private investigator fees, it was hell. And I don't want that to be someone else's story or that to happen to somebody else. So what could I do? Be the change you wish to be. And by sharing my story and by pushing the message and asking for peace and being a voice to hopefully inspire and empower other people of color to stand up for themselves. I survived my assault and my unjustified treatment from the authorities. That's the only thing that separates me from the rest of the victims. And I would feel like such an asshole if I didn't do something with this second chance at life, because they could have killed me. I have a platform to essentially make change, or to touch others, or to relate with others, or to encourage others, or inspire or empower others to also speak up. Things need to change, and not just in our justice system, but there needs to be more culture diversity in our music scenes. We need to lift everybody up. Equality. It's time for a change, and I'm utilizing my platform to push a bigger message.